previous video we discussed about the laws of measurement of performance, Amlin's law, Gustafson's law and Sunny's law. In this video we will discuss about tools for performance measurement. So the motivation behind these algorithms has been to improve the performance and gain a speed up. After the parallel algorithm has been written and executed, the performance of both the algorithm is one of other major concerns. In order to analyze the performance of algorithm, there are various kinds of performance measurement tools. The measurement tools rely not only on the parallel algorithm but require to collect data from the operating system and hardware being used as so as to provide effective utilization of the tools. For a given parallel computer has the number of processor and its computational power increases, the complexity and volume of data for performance analysis substantially increases. So the gathered data for measurement is always very difficult for the tool to store and process it. So the task of measuring performance of parallel program has been divided into two components: performance analysis and performance instrumentation. The performance analysis, it provides the vital information to the programmer from the large chunk of statistics available of the program while in execution mode or from the output data. Performance instrumentation, it emphasizes on how to efficiently gather the information about the computation of the parallel computer. So here is the performance analysis. So performance analysis, in order to measure the performance of the program, the normal form of analysis of program is to simply calculate the total amount of CPU time required to execute the various part of the program. Procedures, however, in case of parallel algorithm running on a parallel computer, the performance metric is dependent on several factors such as inter-process communication, memory, hierarchy. There are the many tools such as analyzer, Incast, Jewel to provide profile of utilization of various resources such as disk operation, CPU utilization, cache performance. So these tools even provide information about various kinds of overheads. Now let us discuss various kinds of performance analysis tools. Search based tools. So the search based tools firstly identify the problem and therefore after appropriately give advice on how to correct it. AT Expert from Cray Research is one of the tools being used for enhancing the performance of Fortran program. With the help of a set of rules which have been written with Cray Auto Tasking Library. So the Cray Auto Tasking Library assists in achieving the parallelism. Basically the AT Expert analyzes the Fortran program, tries to suggest compiler directives that could help in improving the performance of the program. So another tool called Performance Consultant is independent of any programming language model machines. It basically asks three questions: why, where and when about the performance overhead and bottlenecks. So these three questions from three different axes of hierarchical model. One of the important feature of Performance Consultant tool is that it searches for bottlenecks during the execution of program. So the above mentioned feature assists in maintaining the reduced volume of data. So the y-axis present the various bottlenecks such as communication input-output. So the where-axis define the various sources which can cause bottlenecks such as interconnection network and CPU. And the when-axis try to separate the set of bottleneck into specific phase of execution of the program. So let's come to visualization. Visualization is a generic method in contrast to search-based tools. In this method, visual aids are provided like pictures to assist programmer in evaluation the performance of parallel programs. One of the visualization tool is paragraph. The paragraph support various kinds of displays like communication display, task information display and utilization display. So let's come to communication display. Communication display provides support in determining the frequency communication, whether the congestion in message queues or not. So volume and the kind of patterns being communicated. Communication metric. A communication metric is constructed for displaying the communication pattern and size of messages being sent from one processor to another. So the duration of communication etc. in the communication matrix, a two-dimensional array is constructed such that both horizontal and vertical sides are represented with the various processes. It mainly provides the communication pattern between the processes. The rows indicate the processor which is sending the message, column indicate the processor which is going to receive the measure. Now come to communication traffic. The communication traffic provide a pictorial view of the communication traffic in the interconnection network with respect to the time in progress. So the communication traffic displays total number of messages which have been sent but not received, message queues. The message queue provide the information about the size of queues under utilization of various processes. It indicates the size of each processor incoming message queue, which would be varying depending upon the messages being sent, received, buffered as shown. So it may be noted that every processor would be having a limited limit on maximum length of its queue. So this display mainly help in analyzing whether the communication is congestion free or not. Now come to processor hyperqueue. This is a specific tool in this hyperqueue. Here each processor is depicted by the set of nodes of the graph, and the various arcs are represented with the communication link. So the node status can be idle, busy, sending, receiving, etc. and are indicated with the help of specific color. So an arc is drawn between two processors when messages sent from one node to another and is deleted when the message is received. Utilization display. It displays information about the distribution of work among the processors and effectiveness of processor. Utilization summary. The utilization summary indicates the status of each processor, how much time in the form of percentage has been spent by each processor in busy mode, overhead mode and idle mode. So the next one is utilization count. So utilization count displays the status of each processor in a specific mode, busy mode, overhead mode and idle mode with respect to the process in time as shown in the figure of your book and Gantt chart. The Gantt chart illustrates the various activities of each processor with respect to progress in time, idle, overhead, busy mode with respect to each processor. Kivet diagram. The Kivet diagram displays the geometric description of each processor utilization and the load being balanced for various processes. Concurrency profile. The concurrency profile displays the percentage of time spent by various processors in a specific mode, idle, overload, overhead or busy. Task information display. The task information display mainly provide visualization of various locations in the parallel program, where bottleneck have arisen, instead of simply illustrating the issues that can assist in detecting the bottlenecks. With the input provided by the user through portable instrumented communication library PICL, the task information displays provide the exact portion of the parallel program which are under execution. So let's come to instrument performance instrumentation. So the method of instrumentation mainly attempt to capture information about the application by adding some kind of instrument like a code or a function or a procedure into the source code of the program, or maybe at the time of execution. The major effect of such instrumentation is generation of some useful data for performance tools. So performance instrumentation sometimes causes certain problem known as intrusion problem. Thanks for watching.